Again, ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Dupree here tonight live on the hotline at 1-900-909-9900. Give them a call. Kids, get your parents' permission. $1.49 for the first minute, 99 cents for every minute thereafter. Call the hotline right now.
You got four brothers.
Bobby Heenan. Bobby Heenan, please.
Just a minute. What?
Off the horn here, will you?
Tell Marie I said hi.
Okay, yeah.
What do you do? Just socialize on the phone anytime you feel up to it?
Oh, that was Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson?
Yes, he wanted to know if he could be the opening act for Honky Tonk. I don't know how to... I can't make that decision for you.
The Honky Tonk Band is going to have his hands full this coming Wednesday night at the Clash of the Champions as he challenges Johnny B. Badd for the world television title.
Well, yes, he's going to have his hands full, but he's going to come out champion. I know he is. Then he is going to go on a worldwide tour, just sing and dance for the people and display the belt.
That's selling out everywhere.
Everywhere. That's why Michael Jordan just called me. Or Jackson, you know, they're...
Right now, let's go to the ring. Speaking of the Honky Tonk Band, he's ready for action this week against Brad Armstrong.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is the feature attraction. It is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Honkywood, USA, weighing 248 pounds, the Honky Tonk Man.
Gary Michael Capetta making the introductions here on the main event. On the main event, yours truly, Gordon Solie, along with the living legend Larry Zbysko, bringing the action. The Honky Tonk Man facing quite a challenge in this match. Let's take a listen once again to Gary Michael Capetta as he introduces the Honky Tonk Man's adversary for this main event.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in this main event contest. He's from Marietta, Georgia, weighing 233 pounds, Brad Armstrong!
Armstrong getting set to move up against the Honky Tonk Man.
Well, it's going to be a good matchup, too, Gord. You know, Brad Armstrong here, probably the best wrestler of all the Armstrongs, probably the most level-headed and probably the most best conditioned of the Armstrongs here. So Honky Tonk Man, who's a master chess player, will have his hands full with Brad.
He will indeed. And this Wednesday night at the Clash of Champions, he'll have a chance to win that World Television Championship. We'll find out.
Look at the Honky Tonk Man already with the psychological warfare against Brad Armstrong, hugging that corner, taking off the outfit. Look at, uses that ring as an ally. I mean, this guy knows what he's doing. Look how he backs up along the ropes.
Brad Armstrong circling and stalking his man, tries to close in on him. The Honky Tonk Man ducks through the ring ropes. And that way, once again, Brad Armstrong has to back off.
Yeah, see, Armstrong's smart enough to know not to follow him in, because what are you going to do? He's just going to be there in the ropes. So the rest of the Honky Tonk Man, you're basically just going to back off and try to get him to come to you, which is much easier said than done.
Now, the Honky Tonk Man won't be able to use those tactics Wednesday night during the Clash of Champions. Johnny B. Badd will follow him right outside.
You're right there. Look at Armstrong's not rushing into the man. Honky Tonk's already back in the ropes. And Armstrong has no choice but to move out in the middle.
All right, a go-behind by the Honky Tonk Man now. Brad Armstrong hooks that arm and brings him around down to the canvas. And the Honky Tonk Man back on his feet now, gesticulating with those fists. But I got news for you. You're not going to scare Brad Armstrong. Honky Tonk complaining now about his hair being pulled, of all things.
Well, he's playing chess out there is what he's doing. And Armstrong again still kind of waiting in the middle. And I think Honky Tonk Man is trying to get Armstrong psychologically flustered. So Brad rushes into the man. And then Honky Tonk will be there right now, keeping it basic. But Armstrong's one of the guys you want to keep on the mat. And that's where he's got the Honky Tonk Man.
Took him down with a hammerlock, got him off balance, brought him back down to the canvas, and now really beginning to punish the Honky Tonk Man. Of course, you take away an arm or a leg, you're taking away a point of balance, a point of attack, and a point of defense. So that much like a three-legged table, it's not going to stand too well if you take away that mobility. And that's exactly what Brad Armstrong is trying to do now with the Honky Tonk Man.
Brad Armstrong should do something about taking away the ropes.
They lock up collar and elbow, and this time it's the Honky Tonk Man punishing the deltoids of Brad Armstrong. Had a full arm dragon twist.
Yeah, look how the Honky Tonk Man suckered Armstrong, and I mean, Armstrong comes in frustrated, wants to grab the Honky Tonk Man. That makes the mistake, that leaves an opening, and the Honky Tonk Man has got to hold the arm bar on Brad Armstrong. This guy's a great player of human chess.
Now you can see the crowd is certainly not with the Honky Tonk Man.
Yeah, not a very pretty sight.
Full arm dragon twist once again by Brad Armstrong, and this time he has the Honky Tonk Man back down to the canvas.
Hey, Susie gets the Honky Tonk Man where he wants him. Out he goes.
Yeah, he's a good strategy individual, no question about it.
See, Armstrong slowly getting frustrated. I mean, Brad's been around long enough to know better, so all you can do is just sit back in the middle of the ring and wait.
Once again, the Honky Tonk Man back inside the ring. Catches him coming in, a knee to the midsection. Then an elbow to the back of the skull of Brad Armstrong.
Yeah, he caught him sucking in a breath, too. Knocked the wind right out of Brad Armstrong. Armstrong, you know, you can tell when he can't breathe, because otherwise he'd be moving.
3 Faces of Fear face Sting, David Sullivan, and Hulk Hogan Wednesday night during the Clash of Champions.
There you go. Here's the Armstrong you got to have now. Keep the Honky Tonk Man in the middle of the ring and hook him. Don't let him get to those ropes.
All right, the Honky Tonk Man makes it back to his feet. Now goes for the hair of Brad Armstrong. Armstrong broke that one up.
Yeah, Armstrong wants the Honky Tonk Man down the mat. This guy knows too many little tricks of the trade. Again, he's got the wrist lock on him, but it's not enough. Take him down, and Armstrong should know that.
Armstrong still trying to punish the Honky Tonk Man. Still working on that left arm, and that's where he started off at the very origination of this match. Honky Tonk Man drove that knee into the midsection of Brad Armstrong.
Well, Brad, for the second time, got the wind knocked out of him. You know, it's a big atmosphere out there, Gordon, but if you can't keep it in your lungs, it's not going to do you any good.
Once again, it's the Honky Tonk Man closing in on Brad Armstrong. Irish whip caught him with the back of the elbow, coming off the ropes. Brad Armstrong's eyes were crossed that time. He took some punishment to the back, right into the thoracic area, then some punishment to the hands, and
hey, you break a few fingers out there, and it's hard to cradle up somebody.
Is indeed, and Brad Armstrong now moving remarkably slowly against the Honky Tonk Man. The Honky Tonk Man tried to set him for a neck breaker, and Brad Armstrong battling that situation now, realizes the danger. High backdrop on the part of Brad Armstrong, saved himself from a potential damaging position. Now drives a hard right hand into the midsection of the Honky Tonk Man. He drives another hard right hand, then one to the side of the jaw. Oh. Another one to the side of the jaw of the Honky Tonk Man. Brad Armstrong now beginning to explode. And he catches him with another right hand. Smashes his head into the turnbuckle.
He won't be able to sing anymore.
Well, that'd be a blessing, I'll tell you.
Armstrong's got to keep going, though. Don't stop now.
He slowed the pace, and that may have been a mistake. He slides through his legs, but he's caught.
He got him.
Got him with a neck breaker. Let's see if that is a pinfall. Oh, it was indeed.
Ladies Brad and gentlemen, Armstrong lost the winner his momentum. Of the match, the Honky Tonk Man.
You know, he lost his concentration, Gordon. This guy, the Honky Tonk Man, had Brad, I hate to say it, out sight from the beginning. He rope-a-doped him, whatever you call it, and there's the result. Knocked the wind out of Brad two or three times.
I know you want to hear me sing my song.
No, I don't.
Oh, my.
Anyway, good victory for the Honky Tonk Man, a great player of human chess. Lousy singer.
I'll go along with that. He can't sing and he can't play the guitar, but he sure can wrestle.
Dog, baby.
But Brad Armstrong, when Armstrong lost his concentration, lost his momentum. And now you can hear the crowd. They're not happy at all with the
They've lost their hearing.
Well, of course, Honky Tonk Man, Wednesday night goes after Johnny B. Badd in the World Television Championship during the Clash of Champions.
And the Price is Right.
Thank you very much. You've been a beautiful audience.
All right. We're going to take a short commercial break right now. So do stay tuned.
Thank you very much.